and welcome to my big sandbox. My name is Miss Christine, and I am so excited to be with you. The past weeks, we've been celebrating the greatest love, God's love, and it's for everyone. It's true. The most powerful truth of the Bible is that God loves you, and He showed us His love by sending us Jesus. Jesus taught us how to give love to others and how to receive love, and Jesus loves you, and He wants to be your forever friend. So let's celebrate this amazing love with our new worship songs. Everyone stand up.
His love will never quit. His love will never run away. Even when I get upset, His love is still forgiving me. And it's all
Jesus. It makes me smile. Now, everyone, have a seat. Let's get ready to learn. We'll begin by turning on our listening ears. Click, click, click. Wonderful. Thank you for showing me that you're ready to learn. Our Bible question this week asks us, who loves you? And the answer is that Jesus loves me. Let's say that together one more time. Who loves you? Yes, Jesus loves me. Absolutely. Jesus loves you, and He wants to be your forever friend. You can know it and believe it because the Bible tells us so. Proverbs 17:17 says, a friend loves at all times. Let's say that together with our emotions. A friend loves at all times. Proverbs 17:17. Every week, when we get together, we remind ourselves that there are two very important things that we always want to remember about our Bible. First, everything in the Bible is absolutely true. And second, everything in the Bible is powerful. Fantastic. You know, the Bible is God's holy word. It's made up of two big sections, the Old Testament in the front of the Bible, and then the New Testament in the back of the Bible. And there are 66 books in total, 39 books in the Old Testament and 27 books in the New Testament. When we read the Bible, it's like God's talking to us. Isn't that great? Well, I think we're ready for our lesson. This week's true story is straight from the Bible. It is about a very important man who needed Jesus's help. Jesus didn't know this man, but Jesus helped him because Jesus loves everyone. And Jesus teaches us through His actions that we should love and help others too, even if we don't know them. Let's watch.
Just follow me through. Hoo, hoo.
Follow me through. Follow me through, hoo. Oz got a Bible story for me and you.
There you go. You got it. Oh, hi, friends. Stormy and her friend Goldie are playing ball. For a while, Goldie was trying to hold the ball on her nose by herself, and it was hard. But then Stormy came to help, and now they're playing. Isn't that what good friends do? They help each other. Which reminds me of a story. Today's true story from the Bible starts with Jesus walking into a city to do some important work when a centurion came up to him. Wow, look at that cool armor he's wearing. Centurions were leaders in the army. They were big and important. But this centurion believed that Jesus was even more important, and he needed Jesus' help. Jesus, he said, my servant is at home, and he is very, very sick. Please, I need your help to make him better. Now remember, Jesus was busy. He was on his way to do important work. But do you think that stopped him from helping the centurion? No way. Jesus said, do you want me to come to your house and make him better? But the centurion said, Jesus, you are way too special to come to my house. I know you can just say it and he will get better. And that's exactly what Jesus did. Jesus told the centurion to go home and the servant would be all better. And he was. Wow, Jesus is such a good friend. Jesus heard someone needed his help and he helped them. Jesus loved the centurion and his servant just like he loves you. That's why Jesus wants to be your friend forever, because he loves you very much. Oh, hey there, Ollie. Ollie, tell me, who loves you?
Jesus loves me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who loves you?
Jesus loves me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. Bye.
Amazing! The centurion came to Jesus because he believed that Jesus was special. He knew Jesus could help his servant and get rid of his sickness. And Jesus did. The centurion was an important man, but he believed Jesus was more important. The centurion was also different than Jesus, but that didn't stop Jesus from helping him. No way. Jesus loves everyone, no matter what, no matter where they live, no matter how old they are, or what they look like. Jesus loves everyone. And Jesus loves you. God made you, and you are unique and special, and no one else is like you. And that's wonderful. Each of you was made for love, the greatest love, Jesus's love. Jesus loves you so much, and he helps you in all things at all times. Sometimes we don't even know it. Jesus is so amazing. So there are two things I want you to remember from our lesson today. One, Jesus is always here to help you because you are important to him. And two, Jesus loves you and wants to be your forever friend because every child is made for his love. So if I ask you who loves you, you're gonna say, Jesus loves me. Absolutely, you all did great today. It was so fun being with you. Let's get our prayer hands ready to pray. Open and shut them, open and shut them. Give a little clap, clap, clap. Open and shut them, open and shut them. Fold them just like that. Dear God, thank you so much for sending Jesus to be our forever friend. And thank you so much for loving us. No matter who we are, what we've done, what we look like, we are so appreciative that you love us. And that you loved us so much that you sent us Jesus to be our forever friend. Amen. Thanks again, everyone. Remember, Jesus helps you because he loves you, and you are made for his love. See you next time.
Goodbye, we'll see.